Hi, Dr. Huntington here, and in today's video, I'm going to give you the key to having control over the most powerful aging process in your body. It's called glycation. I'll give you tips on how to slow this process down and ways you can even reverse the damage that it does. Glycation happens naturally in your body when a protein or a fat is exposed to a sugar molecule. What happens is they actually bind together to form a harmful compound called advanced glycation end product. Or for short, the acronym is AGE, which of course spells age, right? Both literally and in how these compounds destroy a body. Basically, glycation causes proteins and lipids to no longer function. And worse than that, to actually become harmful to your body. They drive inflammation and oxidative stress. And so these AGE particles need to be scavenged and eliminated from your body. AGEs accelerate the aging process by clogging the blood vessels of major organs like your eyes, your heart, your brain, your kidneys, the same organs that are under attack in diabetics. Now, since sugar creates AGEs, this is the reason diabetics seem to age faster, you know, and they're prone to early onset degenerative illnesses. Now, you can't stop the process of glycation completely, but there are ways to prevent initiating it and reducing the AGE load in your body. Number one is reducing your sugar intake to as close to zero as possible, because sugar feeds glycation, right? And because your body is made up of so many proteins and lipids, you know, the reaction is accelerated by sugar consumption. And this floods your body with AGEs. Remember, eliminating sugar goes, you know, well beyond just getting rid of like the sugar bowl. It means cutting out the carbohydrates that metabolize into sugar, like bread, pasta, crackers, cereals, granola, and you can put alcohol on that list as well because it converts into sugar quickly once you consume it. And of course, staying away from the obvious refined carbs, you know, that contain even more added sugar, like donuts and cookies and pastries. You also need to make sure that you check the labels on things like protein bars and alternative milks for added sugar. You know, you have to be careful because sugar is added to so many products that you'd never even imagine, right? And many are marketed as natural and healthy. So you have to read labels and recognize ingredients, particularly sugar or things that will break down into sugar once you consume them. Now, AGE production is accelerated by certain cooking methods as well, like, you know, browning of food, like through grilling, roasting, and broiling. When you see that browning, it's an indication of the reaction between the protein and sugar. You know, so by using lower heat and wet methods of cooking, like steaming or boiling, poaching, you can avoid creating these AGEs. Now, think of a hamburger patty, right? This would give you an example of what's happening. It's pink and soft when it's raw, but when the protein, the fat, and the sugar in the patty react, it causes the patty to become brown and stiffen. And this is exactly what can happen inside your body when AGEs are abundant. Your tissues, your organs, and your blood vessels can harden and become stiff. Now, to add to the problem, sugar is commonly added to the proteins we cook at high heat. So, you know, things like hot dogs and ribs, and burgers, marinated chicken wings. You know, so to lessen the issue, use marinades that contain no sugar. And when you're looking to buy things in the store, make sure that you check the labels. And if you can also make your own healthy sauce, but just, you know, don't include sugar. And when you're searching or shopping for proteins in the store, do your best to make sure that you can recognize on the labels that you're purchasing proteins that don't have added sugar. Another way to reduce AGEs in your body is with exercise. Now, this reduces glycation by burning available sugar before combined with a protein. But this really only helps the situation, right? It's cutting out sugar in the first place. That is your best way to reduce AGE buildup. So to wrap this up, you know, eliminate what stimulates glycation, and that's sugar. Consume lots of antioxidant-rich vegetables and stick with low-sugar fruits. And certain vitamins can also help to prevent glycation and reverse the damage of AGEs. So there's one called Benfo, which is like a form of vitamin B1 that is fat soluble. And that's one example because it's a powerful aid to slow or stop glycation, and specifically for protecting your nerves. You know, if you want to use Benfo, it's important to know two things. First, it's fat soluble, you know, so it'll get stored in your body. And so you can, if you take too much of it, that buildup can become toxic. And second, it's a derivative of the natural vitamin B1. You know, so you can't really get it from food. I've got it listed up here so you can see it right here. And another one is the active form of vitamin B6, which is pyridoxine or pyridoxal, right? This can actually trap the products of sugar breakdown, you know, before they're involved in glycation. Some good sources of B6, because you can get that directly from food, would include fish or poultry, organ meat, eggs and vegetables. And there's also another one, flavonoid. It's called luteolin, which is found in lemons and cantaloupe and many peppers, celery, radicchio. It's an artichoke in a good volume. It's a powerful anti-inflammatory for tissues with AGE buildup. And of course, consume lots of vitamin C because it's a powerful antioxidant, right? Some great sources are bell peppers, cruciferous vegetables, papaya, and strawberries are a great source as well. And most supplements, of course, will contain vitamin C. So if you want to find all of those places where sugar's hiding in your labels, check out my video called How to Spot and Cut Down on Sugar. All right, I hope I've inspired you to stop glycating so frequently because it's shortening your life. And of course, you can do that by cutting down on your sugar intake. All right, I'll see you in the next one.